गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू टुडे? एंजॉइंग योर डे विद स्मार्टफोन एंड लैपटॉप? आई एम श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू मस्ट बी फैमिलियर विद द इंटरनेट। डू आई नीड टू एक्सप्लेन यू व्हाट इज इंटरनेट? आई डोंट थिंक सो। एज यू आर ऑलरेडी सर्चिंग फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन वर्ल्ड वाइड वेब, attending online classes and using email and WhatsApp, all these are part of the internet. So I am Arun Soni, a cybersecurity trainer. And today we will travel to cyberspace. This cyberspace is keep on growing. By the way, do you know what is this cyberspace? Cyberspace is the online world of computer networks and especially the internet. As you know that Internet is the network of networks. All social media accounts like Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter, your email services, online classes, and information you search on the internet is part of the cyberspace. So cyberspace is a parallel world. And yes, I want to you to stay alert. Don't sleep. Because we have to know how to stay protected in the cyberspace. As you know, because of COVID situation, we are doing everything online. Even studies and office work is being done with the help of internet. But there are also lots of bad people on the internet which steal our work, photos and information like phone number, address and even track you wherever you go. We have to protect ourselves from those bad people. And if you are sleeping like you do in your math class, you won't be able to learn it. So stay alert. Wow, earlier mom did not let me touch the phone, but now I daily use it for online classes and other things. It's so fascinating. But do you know how to handle a smartphone? What you need to do in order to protect yourself on the internet? First of all, you should make sure that you have a good quality purchased antivirus, like Kaspersky, Bitdefender, Sophos, install in your computer. Because we can never be sure of anything when we are online. Any website or email can install bad programs called malware in your smartphone. So we need to make sure that we have a good antivirus in our phone. Do not download free antivirus. Always use a reliable and a purchased antivirus for the mobile phone. These antiviruses are not expensive, maybe 500 rupees for a year, and it secures your phone forever. You just renew your subscription every year and your phone is protected. आई यूज कस्पर स्काई. एंड सेकेंड इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट ऑलवेज इंस्टॉल एप्स फ्रॉम ऑफिशियल एप स्टोर्स विद परमिशन ऑफ योर पेरेंट्स. यू नो एंड्रॉयड फोन्स दे हैव गूगल प्ले स्टोर, iOS फोन दे हैव एप स्टोर. एंड नेवर इंस्टॉल एप्स फ्रॉम लिंक्स सेंड थ्रू SMS और ईमेल. ऑलवेज डाउनलोड एप्स फ्रॉम द ऑफिशियल एप स्टोर ऑफ योर मोबाइल फोन एंड ओनली डू इट विद परमिशन ऑफ योर पेरेंट्स, बिकॉज दे आर सो मैनी काइंड ऑफ एप्स आर देयर इन एप स्टोर्स एंड सम आर नॉट एज अप्रोप्रिएट एंड सम कैन हैव मॉलवेयर ऑल्सो. सम विल आस्क फॉर यू अनरीजनेबल परमिशंस. ओनली योर पेरेंट्स कैन गाइड यू दैट विच ऐप इज सेफ फॉर यू. आई एम श्योर दैट यू मस्ट बी यूजिंग व्हाट्सएप और सम अदर मैसेजिंग सर्विस लाइक सिग्नल और टेलीग्राम. एंड नॉर्मली इन व्हाट्सएप वी हैव ग्रुप्स. लाइक इट इज़ पॉसिबल दैट योर टीचर मे हैव क्रिएटेड ए ग्रुप फॉर योर क्लास और फॉर योर सेक्शन, सो दैट इफ शी वॉन्ट्स टू टेल यू समथिंग शी विल जस्ट पोस्ट इन द ग्रुप एंड ऑल ऑफ यू कैन रीड इट. बट इट इज वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट यू डू नॉट जॉइन एनी अननोन ग्रुप. Because misinformation can be shared in unknown groups, someone can bully you, and you should also take care that you should not spread any misinformation or unethical post in the group. And if you are admin, then do not add unknown people to your group. And in case if you ever contacted by a stranger through medium like SMS, call, social media, WhatsApp, etc., immediately inform your parents or teachers. It is very much possible that when you are using the internet, you get messages from strangers on social media or maybe on WhatsApp. Do inform your parents or teachers immediately. Those can be bad people trying to be friend with you, because this internet world is very, very big and you don't know who is sitting behind a computer. Is he a good person? Is he a bad person? What are his or her intentions? We don't know anything. So you need to be very careful. Just read this. This is a dialogue between daughter and her dad. Daughter was very fascinated that she has met a person that is just like her. He watches same movies, he plays same games which she plays. But her dad was very intelligent. He told her that this is wrong. You should not have talked to unknown person and share any details. He can be older, he can be criminal, he can be a kidnapper. Never meet a person whom you do not know online as well as offline too. and there is a new development. Sometimes you get an unexpected email, an unexpected e-card on your birthday, and you get very excited. And this girl is just going to send a thank you e-card to the person to whom she does not know. And luckily she told her mother that somebody has sent her an e-card. Now let's see that what her mother is going to tell her. No, don't do it. Just block that person. That person is trying to be friendly with you and then will ask to send pictures or other details like house address and phone numbers. He can be anyone with bad intentions. And she was thanking God that her daughter told her about this. And in the same way, you should also tell your parents whenever somebody tries to contact you through the internet. I'm sure that you must be knowing about Google Maps. Learn to use Google Maps. It's a very useful app. In case when you are lost in a market or in a new place when gone for a vacation, you can use Google Maps to reach home or wherever your parents are. You just need to put the location and the Google Map will guide you through the path, where to turn, where to go straight, how many kilometers are away, how many meters are away from you are from your home. So learn to use Google Maps. Do you know that Google Maps are the satellite and aerial images taken by cameras on the satellite and aircraft and combined later on? Yes. And now you see QR codes everywhere. Even printed in newspapers. Scan this QR code to know more about this product. Scan this QR code to make payment. But these QR codes can be very dangerous too. Malicious QR code can install malware in your smartphone and steal information from your phone. I am not saying that every QR code is malicious, but QR codes scanned from untrusted sources or sent by unknown people are definitely very harmful. You should not scan QR codes until and unless it is very necessary and are pasted at a very reputed place. So avoid scanning QR codes as much as you can. Even it can, if you scan a wrong QR code, it can take control of your mobile phone. It can take control of the camera of your mobile phone. Somebody can watch you through the camera of your mobile phone, can make video of you, can take pictures of you. Anything can happen if you scan a wrong QR code. So be very cautious while scanning a QR code. Wow, now I have a laptop too. Earlier my father didn't allow to work me on the laptop, but now for the whole day I am on the laptop. But stop you must know a few things before you start using it. First of all, the same thing, that you should have a good quality purchased antivirus like Kaspersky, Bitdefender, Norton installed in your computer, means in your laptop or your PC. An antivirus can protect your laptop or PC from malware, which are harmful programs and can steal and share your personal information like your name, mobile number, with bad people on the internet. Just imagine a thief knows that you have gone for a vacation and your house is empty, or a bad person knows your parents' mobile number and keep calling them from fake IDs. This can be very serious. And when you open a website, you will see so many ads like, click here to win a free iPad, click here to win a free trip to Goa, or click here to scan your computer with free antivirus. Don't click on any such link, because clicking on such random links will install malware in your computer, and again your computer can get hacked. Your personal information will go to some bad person. Bank details stored in your computer will go to some bad person, and anything can happen. So now it is your responsibility to make sure that you do not click on any link which does not concern you, especially the links which give you free offer. Those can be very harmful. And do not go to any website told by a friend or unknown person. Your computer can get virus if that website is not clean. Avoid visiting random websites by clicking on random links. Open only those websites which your teachers and parents permit. Otherwise, if you want to open a website, take permission of your parents or teachers before opening that website. It can save you from many, many problems. And if you have installed a good antivirus, it will give you warnings like, stop, this is a phishing website, this website is not safe, this file is not safe to open. Don't ignore that warning, because otherwise your computer can get virus or your information can get leaked to bad persons. If your antivirus says stop, then stop opening that file or website. Do not ignore this warning. Otherwise, your laptop or PC get infected with malware. And you know what malware is. Malware are bad programs that steal information from your mobile or from your laptop or PC. Do not chat with anyone online except your known ones. Bad older people can act children to talk to you. You know, if you play online games, avoid chatting with unknown children. They may not be children of your age, but bad older people who wants to get your personal information or passwords from you. Because you don't know who is sitting behind the computer. You can't see. They are just typing. And you don't know who is typing that sentence. That could be a child. Or that could be a 40 years person. That could be a 60 years person. So make sure that you do not interact with anybody on the internet to whom you do not know. And when we open websites, there are a lot of pop-ups. Click here, download this, get discount, click here to get 20% discount. Do not click on any pop-up to buy anything or visit any website. These pop-up can install virus or steal your personal information. What you can do is you can install a pop-up blocker extension in your browser, like Adblock. It is a very good pop-up blocker extension for your browser that will automatically block the unwanted advertisements and pop-ups before they open in your browser. So you can take help of your parents to get that extension installed in your browser. And all of us are doing online shopping. I also do so much of shopping, all online now. So, first rule is always purchase an item from a trusted online shopping website like Amazon, Flipkart. These are the trusted websites. But now I have seen that so many new websites are coming up which are giving 70% discount or 80% discount on many things, on expensive things. But if you do shopping from such new websites which are giving unbelievable discount, your debit card or credit card details can get captured and misused by bad actors. They can buy some product for themselves using those details, or the payment will be deducted from your account, from your parents' account, but the product will never reach you. So always be suspicious of new online shopping websites giving high discounts. Don't be a greedy fox. Stick to a regular website which your parents use to do online shopping. Do not force them to buy your favorite item from a new website. It can result in financial loss. And there are some golden rules of cyber safety. Golden rules which means the rules which everyone should follow. And you should remember it by your heart. First of all, do create strong passwords. And don't share your password. Like you don't share your toothbrush, you don't share your password. Not even with your friends. And do not keep a weak password like your mobile number, your dog's name, your something like your favorite sport, etc. Below you can see that a strong password is like this. A weak password is like this. Whenever you are using an email or some social media account, create a strong password. A strong password is a combination of lowercase letters, uppercase letters, numbers and symbols. And it is at least 10 characters long. So remember to create strong passwords always. Do not share personal information. Do not give your personal information like phone numbers, address, city, etc. to anyone online. Do not fill survey forms which are asking for these kind of information unnecessarily. Providing your personal information to anyone online can make you vulnerable to online threats and cyberbullying or harassment. Next is think before you click. Do not click on any email from any stranger, pop-ups and other unfamiliar links and websites. Below you can see that this is the link. You don't know what this link leads to. It can install a malware on your laptop. It can take you to a malicious website which will steal your information. Anything can happen if you click on a link and that link is not clean. Make it a permanent habit. Never ever click on any link about which you do not know or sent by some unknown people. You can make use of a website that is virustotal.com that can scan a link or a file with 50 or more free legal antiviruses. So remember this, www.virustotal.com, and share issues with parents and teachers. Immediately tell your parents or teachers if someone even known to you sends you disturbing messages. The person can be your friend. If any message makes you feel uncomfortable, even sent by a friend, do tell your teacher and parents immediately. The process should stop immediately. If somebody is sending you that you are not looking good, I hate you, or something like that, which you do not feel good about, then do tell it to a trusted person. And now the final do's and don'ts of the internet. Let us revise the final do's and don'ts of the internet. We can call it cyber hygiene. Like you daily take a bath and brush your teeth to maintain physical hygiene, good practices on the internet is called cyber hygiene. Always be polite to others on the internet. Do not talk to strangers. Do not give away the personal information. If someone unknown person is sending you messages, tell parents and teachers immediately. Be very cautious while installing apps in your mobile phone. Always have an antivirus for your mobile phone and laptop both. Always create strong passwords. All these are digital hygiene basically. And how smart you are. S is for stay safe. Don't give out your personal information to people, places you don't know. M, don't meet up. Meeting someone you have only been in touch with online can be dangerous. I again repeat, dangerous. Always check with an adult you trust before you decide to meet someone. A is for accepting files. Accepting emails, files, pictures or texts from people you don't know can cause problem. R is for reliable. Check information before you believe it is. Is the person or the website telling the truth or it is some fake information? Tell someone. Tell an adult if someone or something makes you feel worried or uncomfortable. So follow these smart tips and keep yourself safe online. Now something for parents. I assume that parents are also sitting with their children, their kids. So they should make sure that children and young people should be supported to understand that when they use digital technology, they should not give out personal information, particularly their name, address or school mobile phone numbers to anyone they do not know or trust. You know, these days people use social engineering. Social engineering is basically taking advantage of goodness of people. So they can con you, they can make your child disclose the information. They will say that, maybe they say, I'm your neighbor, please, I have to send an urgent email and my Wi-Fi is not working, कैन यू प्लीज़ गिव मी पासवर्ड ऑफ योर वाईफाई एंड योर चाइल्ड माइट गिव पासवर्ड ऑफ योर वाईफाई. सो टेल योर चाइल्ड नॉट टू शेयर एनी टाइप ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन और नॉर द गैजेट्स. And this particularly includes social networking and online gaming sites. If they have been asked for such information, they should always check with their parents or other trusted adults before providing such details. It is also important that they understand why they must take a parent or trusted adult with them if they meet someone face to face whom they have only previously met online. Which kind of troubles they can put you in? This only parents can explain, because these are very subtle things, they are very subtle points which only parents can explain to their children. This is cyber psychology. So these are takeaway for parents too. They must understand at least this much. This webinar has lasted only 30 minutes or so, but now it is parents' duty to take the learning forward. And thank you very much for being alert and listening to me. And I hope you are not sleeping. Be alert, be cyber safe. This is my website. And if you want to contact me, if you have any question, you can WhatsApp me at this number 9815204980. Okay. So be alert, be cyber safe. Bye bye. Have a good day.